Okay, so here I have my two kokanees that were caught today. The first one I'm just going to cut behind that fin on either side, trying not to cut through the entire body. So when we pull off the head, all the guts will come with it. As you can see here, I do take the guts and I throw them into the lake, and that will feed other species. Now with the guts removed, I'm going to cut open the remainder of the body and remove anything else inside. Now with the fish cleaned out completely, what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove some scales. I am going to be removing the skin later, but I just want to remove some scales just to make it easier to work with and not create such a mess. Now with majority of the steel, rinse it off, and now we will be filleting the fish. And I'm just doing this the way I know how. I know there's many other ways to do it. Just work your way from the front all the way to the tail, keeping your knife as flat as possible. As you can see, there are still some bones in there, but those will be removed later on when I go to cook the fish. And this way leaves a very minimal amount of meat on the fish. Most of the meat is in the fillet. And there you go. Beautiful fillets. Okay, here we have our fillets. And I'm just going to remove the rib bones. I am also going to remove the belly fat and clean off the excess on the sides. And I do also take out the pin bones. I have a pin bone remover. I know most of them will cook away in the cooking process, but I prefer not to have any bones. And the people that are eating it prefer not to have any bones. So it's easy enough for me to remove those. As you can see, I'm just running my hand along just to feel those pin bones so I can easily remove them. And here's the finished product after all the bones have been removed and they're cut up into small portions to prep for the fryer. And as you guys know by the subject, I am making fish tacos. So we're going to put some tomato in, some avocado, some store-bought mix. It's like a coleslaw. I'm just using sour cream just to keep it really basic. Some lemon and some cilantro. Now with everything cut up, I'm just going to pull the coleslaw out, and this has no dressing. Again, we'll just use the sour cream as the dressing. Now here is some flour. We're going to add some beer. It's a lager beer, and we're just going to mix it to the consistency that I like, which is pretty runny. Again, that's going to be for a less of a coat on the fish when we're done. If you prefer a larger coat, make it thicker, but here I'm going to mix it fairly thin, and you'll see the final product in a minute. So here it is cooking. Be careful. The oil's too hot, you'll burn them. If you have it just perfect, they'll be golden. As you can see, the ones on the top are golden, the ones on the bottom are a little bit dark. But I ate those too. So here's our tacos. We have sour cream already on, some coleslaw, some fresh tomatoes, which will be going on as well. Next up, we're going to add some avocado. You gotta have that avocado. Make sure you put lots of that on. Now we're going to add some cilantro to the top. And we're going to finish that off with our beer battered coconut. And then we're just going to squeeze some lime juice onto the top. And there you have it, some complete fish tacos.
Voila! That's good.
Delicious! Please like and subscribe to our channel.
Just got home from a 9-day camping trip. Hope you guys enjoyed my catch and cook video. If you could hit the like and subscribe button down below, that would be greatly appreciated. If you'd like to see more videos like this, please comment in the description below. Have a great day.